हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून। चैप्टर नंबर 14, कम्युनिकेशन एंड द नेटवर्क कॉन्सेप्ट। सो एज इन द यूनिट नंबर 3, द कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क हैज बीन इंट्रोड्यूस। सो फर्स्ट थिंग टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द नेटवर्क। So first is what is a network, need for the networking, evaluation of the networking. After that, the switching techniques. We will not learn about these things now. After that, the transmission media, types of network, network topology, network devices, etc. So first we learn network. So question is, what is the network? So see, Tannenbaum define a network as an interconnected collection of the autonomous computer. So actual definition is a two computers are said to be interconnected if they are capable of exchanging information. Central of this definition is fact that the computers are autonomous. This means that no computer on the network can start, stop or the control another. In the simple word, you can say that the two computers are said to be interconnected if they are exchanging the information as well as sharing the resources is called the network. So you can note my definition. Two computers are said to be interconnected if they are capable of exchanging the information and sharing the resources is called the network. Now, second question, the need for the networking. So, number one, resource sharing. Means that we need the networking, number one, for the resource sharing. Resource sharing means the hardware sharing, like the printer, scanner, modem, etc. are called the resources in the networking. The aim is to be make all the program data and the peripherals available to anyone on the network, irrespective of the physical location of the resource and the user. Okay, so now after that, the second need is the reliability. A file can have the copied on the two or the three different machines. So if the one of the them is unavailable, the other copies could be used for military, banking, air reservation, and the many other application. It is of the great importance. Third, the cost factor. Personal computers have better price performance ratio than the microcomputer. So it is a better to have PCs one per user with the data stored on one shared file server machine. And the fourth one is a communication medium. Using the network, it is a possible for managers working far apart to prepare the financial report of the company. That changes at one end can be immediately noticed at the another, and the hence it speed up cooperation among them. Application of networking. So first application of networking is the sharing the resources as well as sharing the data and the information. So first is a peripheral means the hardware means that we can share the printer, scanner, etc. in the computer, in the networking. Second thing, the user of the multi-user system can share and exchange information. Because the networking support the multi-users, therefore user can exchange their information to the another computer system. So two sharing resources is the sufficient. After that, access to remote database. Suppose the database is stored in the remote computer system, then the everyone can share the information, file, data, etc. from that computer system, which is in the networking, can be accessed. So another major area of the network used to access the remote database, it is easy for the average person sitting at this PC to make the reservation for airplanes, train, hotels, and so on, anywhere in the world with the instant confirmation. Then the communication facility. So this is another application of the networking. A third category of the potential widespread network use is as a communication medium. It is possible for everyone, not just people in the computer business, to send and receive electronic mail. This mail is also able to contain the digitized while still pictures and even moving television and the video images. Now the evaluation of the network. So in evaluation of the network, everybody knows the first network was the ARPANET, and that this network was the designed and the developed by the Department of the Defense of the US in the year 1969, and the ARPANET stand for the Advanced Research Project Agency Network. Or you see this picture, in this picture you are seeing that the, in 1969 the ARPANET, 1980 NFNet, or 1990s internet introduced in the world. Internet. What is the internet? Internet is the worldwide network of the computers network, or in the simple word you can say that the internet is the network of networks. Clear? Then that is given here, the how does it work. This is not in your syllabus. Internet functioning. The two important things, the what is the TCP and the IP. So you note this thing, the TCP means the transmission control protocol part is responsible for dividing the file message into the packet on the source computer. It is also responsible for reassembling the receive packet at the destination or the recipient computer. And the IP, it is called the Internet Protocol part, is responsible for handling the address of the destination computer so that the each packet is the routed to its proper destination. You shall learn about the TCP IP in the detail later in the chapter. So there is a no need to read the TCP and the IP in detail. So you have to note this thing, the TCP and the IP, because these two words are the important for the examination. Now the interspace. So you note only the definition, the interspace. Interspace is a client server software program that allow multiple users to communicate online with the real-time audio, video, and the text chat in a dynamic 3D environment. So you also note the definition of the interspace in your copy. Then the some terminology of the network. Number one, the node. Everybody know the node or the workstation means the computer which is connected in the networking is called the workstation or the node. Then the server. Server The definition of the server is given here. A server, a computer. What is a server? Server is a computer. A computer that facilitate the sharing of data, software, and the hardware resources. For example, the printer, modem, etc. On the network is the term as a server. So you note this. Note the definition of the server in your copy. There are the two types of the server, non-dedicated and the dedicated server. Non-dedicated server on the small network workstation that can develop as a server is known as a non-dedicated server. And the dedicated server on the bigger network installation, there is a computer reserved for the server job, and its only job to help the workstation access data, software, hardware, resources, etc. Then the network interface unit. In network interface unit, a standalone computer. What is the meaning of the standalone computer? Everybody understand the computer which is not in the networking is called the standalone computer. Lives its own world, carries out the task with its own inbuilt resources, but the soon it become as a workstation. It need interface to help establish a connection with the network, because without this the workstation will not be able to share the network resources. So network interface card, network interface card and the network interface unit. So first we understand what is the meaning of the network interface unit. A network interface unit is an interpreter that helps establish communication between the server and the workstation. So please note this definition. After that, the example of the network interface unit is the NIC, N-I-C, network interface card. So network interface card is the device which is used to connect your computer system to the network, and each and the every network interface card has its the physical address, which is called its the MAC address. So what is the MAC address? The MAC address refer to the physical address assigned by the NIC manufacturer. Means that this address is assigned by the NIC manufacturer. After that, the switching technique, there is no need to read these things. The circuit switching, message switching, packet switching, you can ignore it. After that, data communication terminology, so you can ignore it. Bandwidth, data transfer rate, then the transmission meter. This is a very important thing. The transmission media. So everybody know that there are the two types of the transmission media. First one is called the cable or the physical media, or second is called the wireless media. So some example, the twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, and the fiber optic cables. These belongs to the physical media cable. So first we see the twisted pair cable. In the twisted pair cable, you see the two wires, and these two wires are the twisted one over another. Now the some advantage and the disadvantage of the twisted pair cable. So you can see the twisted pair cable in picture. See, this is the twisted pair cable. There are the two wires, and both the wires are insulated. So some advantage, it is a simple, second it is easy to install and maintain. It is physical flexible, it has the two low weight, it can be easily connected, it is a very inexpensive. Disadvantage, despite having the such advantage, the data transmission characteristic of the twisted pair cable is not so good. because the high attenuation, it is incapable carrying the signal over the long distance without the use of the repeater. Its low bandwidth capabilities make it unsuitable for the broadband application. It supports the maximum data rates, the 1 Mbps without conditioning and the 10 Mbps with the conditioning. Then the types of the twisted pair cable, no need to read it. Coaxial cable. Coaxial cable. You have seen the coaxial cable at your home. Your TV is connected. Your TV is connected with your set-top box with this cable. So there is a outer sheet, after that the wire mesh, then the insulator, and after that you see the conductor. There are some advantages and the disadvantages of the coaxial cable. You have learned in the previous classes, so once again we revise the data transmission advantage. The data transmission characteristics of the coaxial cables are considerably better than those of the twisted pair cables. The coaxial cable can be used as the basis for the shared cable network. The coaxial cable can be used for the broadband transmission, that is, several channels can be transmitted simultaneously, offer high bandwidth up to the 400 Mbps. Disadvantage: expensive compared to twisted pair cable. Second, the coaxial cable are not compatible with the twisted pair cable. Okay, then the optical fiber cable. The optical fiber cable consists of the thin strand of the glass and the glass like material, which are so constructed that they carry light from the source at the one end of the fiber to a detector at the other end. The light sources used are either light emitted diode or the laser diode. The data to be transmitted as modulated onto the light beam using the frequency modulation technique. The signals can then be picked up at the receiving end and demodulated. The bandwidth of the medium is the potentially very high. The LEDs, the range between the 20 to 150 Mbps, and the higher rates are the possible using the LEDs. So fiber cable consists of the three pieces, the core. You see, this is called the core, the glass or the plastic through which the light travels. Then the cladding, you see the middle part, the cladding, which is a covering of the core that it reflects the light back to the core. And the third thing, the protecting cable, which is the protect the fiber cable from the hostile environment. Some advantage and the disadvantage. First, we see the advantage. It is the immune to electrical and the magnetic interference, noise in any form, because the information is traveling on the modulated light beam. It is highly suitable for the harsh and industrial environment. It guarantees secure transmission and has the very high transmission capacity. Fiber optic cables can be used for the broadband transmission. Disadvantage the installation problem. Fiber optic cables are quite fragile and may need special care to make them sufficiently robust for the office environment. Second disadvantage, the connecting the either the two fiber together or a light source to a fiber is a difficult process. Because of the noisy immunity, the optical fibers are the virtually impossible to tap. Third, fourth, light can reach the receiver out of the phase. Fifth, the connection losses are the common problem. Fiber optic cables are the more difficult to solder. They are most expensive of all of the cables. Then the wireless communication, wireless media, in which you will see only the microwave. radio wave. Satellite or the microwave. Other unguided media means the wireless is the infrared. You have seen the all the TV remote or any type of the remotes are using the infrared technology. Then the laser transmission. After that, the types of network. So I will make the another file. Now I stop.